Boa tarde, bom dia, boa noite.
Good afternoon, good morning, good night to all of you that are participating to this version of our first festival of Latitude. And at first, I would like to thank especially to the Goethe-Institut Salvador for the invitation. Also, for the artistic residency Villa Sul, I'd like to also thank the Goethe-Institut for this opportunity to communicate, to connect in complicated times, in times that the social contact should be avoided. And I would like to also let all know, the ones you're watching us, I'd like to let you know that you can write to us through the social media. You can ask questions or write comments that we're going to save a time in the end of our conversation, especially to answer to any of your questions or react to your comments. Or any comments you'd like to make about it. And it's a short presentation before presenting our invited. My name is Renata Martins. I am Brazilian. I was born in São Paulo, but I'm living in Germany, in the city of Bonn, for 2 years now. And I work with art criticism. I write art criticisms. I'm also in curator projects. And I am a social educator. And this year, besides of all of the turbulence, it was a very special year that I believe not only to myself, but also to other three colleagues of mine, that in this exact moment, we would be in Salvador of Bahia, in the Goethe Institute, sharing experiences and sharing works, exchanging knowledge with my other three colleagues. That would be exactly the residence group Villa Sul. So this group would be formed in person with a movie maker from Canada, also by Thó Simões, that is a visual artist from Angola. And it's especially with him that I'm going to have the pleasure to share this space, this virtual space, for the next 40 minutes. And before I pass the word on to Thó, I'd like to make a small presentation of him. He is born in 1973 in the city of Malanje, a city that is about 400 kilometers from Luanda, the capital of Angola. And so he dedicates himself to painting, to performances, to urban art, to digital art, to movies, photography. And his background started in the National Union of Plastic Artists, in the National Institute of Art and Culture, both of them in Luanda. He is a natural investigator and curious about the nature. He, through his art, he mixes the influences of traditional African art with the urban arts of the whole globe, the modern arts. And so Africa and Angola, they make an important paper in his work. And in the streets of Luanda, where he's constantly seen, could be with exhibitions of his work, or could be with observing, or simply with absorbing the influence of its surroundings, that really gets a form through his graffitis and his paintings, and also in his performances. And closing this short presentation, I cite Thó, my work does not obey to rules. It's easier to say that I'm simply an artist. And finishing this short biography, Thó, I would like to make you the first question. In the end of all, who is and what do the multi-discipline artist Thó Simões want to express?
Eu acho que você precisa ligar o
Obrigado,
seu...
Renata.
I think you need to turn on your microphone.
Obrigado,
thank you very much. Thank you very much, Renata, for the introduction. I would like to take this opportunity to talk about what you've said about the world. Good morning, good afternoon, good night. I'm here in Angola, I would be in the Institute Goethe-Salvador for all of the honor. I've been working with the Goethe-Institut for a few years now, for 2 or 3 years. And it's been very, very important for my career and in my evolution as a visual artist that I got this partnership. It was very important for me. And the question that you've done to me, what is Thó Simões as an artist? Yes, the question would be, who is? And what does do you want to express this artist, multi-directional artist, Thó Simões? I, as an artist, when I started, I had boundaries because I believe it can really limit your intentions. And as my intention at first, or at least the way that I comprehend it, is never finished. You have to run for the same thing. I cannot have quite a definition of Thó Simões as an artist. I think the easier way that I found to do it was using figures, style figures to define. For example, it's as if I was trying to be an interpreter of my own experiences as a human being in my relationship to the world, of the thing that I can absorb, that I can translate, that I can bring to my work, and also of the relationship that I have with the world of my ideas, with all of the influences, and the way that I encounter to translate this into my work in the format that I am able to do that I'm able to transfer. And it's practically that. I act as an interpreter between my imaginary world and the real world. And so inside of this context, this global context of the pandemics that led all of the people to simultaneously to put another meaning to everything around us. How are you dealing with that in the actual days in Angola? Under which conditions of work are you having to deal with? If you have any special projects that it's been developed, especially for the situation that we're going through, and which kind of project would that be? Exactly. I usually say that I can't quite have a definition. I can't still translate the result of the impact of the pandemic. Because every day I've been reading, I've been taking one day at a time due to the current situation. Before the pandemics, I had projects and I had plans, I had an agenda that it was filled with so many things. and it was easy to coordinate this agenda, and I was able to execute it. But in the actual circumstance, everything has a lot of chaos around it due to several factors, several reasons. First, because it's a pandemic that has impacted massively the whole world, and in another way, my actual day is Africa. I'm from an African country in the African continent. My reality is African. Even the difficulties, the challenges, it's all one or two or three times bigger than in other parts of the world. And being like that as a professional, independently artist, it's extremely important how every day we need to search strength to actually fight against it. And it's a feeling that we are being dragged into an abyss, and we have to fight against this wave. We have to swim against the force of the wind, of the currents. And right now, in this moment, the important thing is not to sink, is to really fight against the waves. And I don't have provisions. I can't predict what is going to happen. We are already on this for practically 2 months now. And I'm still living each day. Because everything has been cancelled, all of my projects. And it's a good thing that independently of all that I lost the opportunity to be with you in the Vila Sul residency. It's a good thing that there is the solution, this digital format, to keep on working together. And it's been really, really useful for me to be able to find other alternatives to work and to be able to transform my work, transform my projects into a real reality to another, because in some way I also have as a consequence, I have in the nature of my work, I've had the fact that of working in distance with what the reality presents to me. I don't actually planify my projects, having as a basis in big productions. I do my work based on that data of a circumstance and of my continent. And so all of the situation ends up giving me a stage to be able to build something, to build new approaches. And inside of this context, I've been using this experience to be able to build my current projects. One of my features of my work is the adaptation to the circumstance.
Você citou a questão do formato digital.
You quoted the format, the digital format that we had to adapt and to try new languages of communication, of and I would really like to know from you that, in a word, without supposedly the best thing would be for us to be present in Salvador right now, but has been brought up this new idea of reinventing in a digital work, in a completely virtual work. How has this experience been for you? I mean, including the context of the residency Vila Sul, how has it been for you, this contact with the Brazilian public virtually?
Eu gostaria de usar o termo maravilhoso.
I'd like to use the term wonderful, because really, if we didn't have this context, the scenery is not really good, but the experience itself has been wonderful, because it allows me to continue on working in an intense way. It allows us to achieve and to be achieved as well by other kinds of publics. It really allows me to look, because, for example, I have been so fascinated about the workshop that we're doing, because it allows me to be able to look at the way how my work is interpreted by other people. And it ends up that it does the paper, because when you're an artist, despite of having a root always connected to the visual, to the visual works, I really learn everything by myself. So in my process of elaboration, in my process of professionalism, which connects to the plastic process, and being that way, I feel that I feel more freedom with among of all of this chaos to be able to build with other people. But now I am not sure, meaning you cannot be sure about the message, if the message that it's been understood the way that you interpreting it. And the feedback that I received is that I am really fulfilling my paper, the paper that I assigned to me. So it's been really wonderful, all of these experiences, especially in these times that we're going through right now, of so many uncertainties, about the future of the arts. We don't know how that is going, the future of the professional of the arts. So it's not good for us to be in this limbo, not knowing how it's going to be like. So this solution, these kinds of solutions are very important for artists like me and also for my colleagues around the world to be able to maintain the work. So just clarifying for whoever's watching us right now, what will be this workshop that you just mentioned? It's a workshop specifically of analysis of its works that is being done online. I am doing the paper as a tutor, and it's very interesting because they are participants from all over Brazil, from many different cities of Brazil, with so many experiences and knowledges. And we started to do an exercise, a very interesting exercise, which was, before having any kind of information about you, I propose that all of them would look at the work, including, if you allow me, I'm going to show a few images of your work, so that the people that are watching us and don't really have lots of contact with your work, so that they have the chance to see it. So I'm going to show right now. I believe that we need the liberation of the authorization of the festival. Moment, please.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Então, o que a gente vai fazer é o seguinte, eu vou...
So, what we're going to do now is, I'm going to... At the same time that I'm going to show a few images of your works that you sent to us.
Share. Sim. Não? E... A primeira tarefa que a gente teve como
the first task that we had as a group of analysis was the people would look at your paintings and they had to cite keywords that would come immediately to their minds when they had a contact to your work. So I'm going to read to you a few of these terms that your art really provoked in the Brazilian public.
Identidade,
artivism,
picho,
identity,
resistência,
picho,
resistance,
textura, ancestrality,
arte africana,
textures,
hibridismo,
African art,
cores,
hybridism,
e urbanidade.
Colors,
então, essa foi
and urbanity. So this was the first
contato.
The first contact that these people had, and the expressions, the way that they reacted to all of these waves of such rich images that you allowed for us to have. And in a second moment, they wrote a few short texts analyzing a few aspects, something specific, having as a starting point this first impression that they had of your work. So I'm going to read to you a few of these analyses that they've done. Looking at the images of Thó, I feel affection. I see that they look at me, they talk to me, and they really affect me. In a first encounter with the work of Thó Simões, I was instigated with a species of contradiction, a calm kind of contradiction between the organic images of the bodies and the ideas of the graffiti. And so we move forward. The use of the graffiti by Thó Simões allows the approach to the themes of today's time and the history of its territory. The composition of the colors done by Thó Simões in his works is responsible for creating a lot of life that comes out of it. I realize in the art of Thó Simões a dialogue to the breaking of the control that lives lots of centuries and is able to control, to hide, and to embarrass the human bodies and its expressions. Bodies that carry a message through the intervention of the artist. So, Thó, how do you react to these assimilations of the Brazilian public or the reception of the Brazilian public to your works? Well, I took really lots of years and ears to be able to do that. The public just simply for the way that you've told me, the way that I'm looking at it. And it's exactly that, actually. I've always used the visual arts as a form of expression, and exactly in my personal experiences, they end up translating exactly in what you've just told me, my realities, being them about my childhood, about my education, or my social position inside of a community, They always ended up being translated exactly into this work. And they would always translate these points of views that you've said. They were translated through the way that it's been looked at it, and it's really fantastic. So, to connecting to what you've just said, this morning, I think in the first encounter that we had in the festival, our colleague, she made a very interesting question that I would like to apply to you right now. How should the art reflect the social injustice in your point of view? I can't give a point of view. My point of view is that in my point of view, the art should be absolutely free. The way I see it, the art is so powerful and it's so above any other kinds of conditions that, from my point of view, we can't actually shape it, because the art manifests in the way that it's been interpreted, in the way that it's been communicated. So from my point of view, it is something that do not have chains. It does not have a specific shape. It doesn't have even a concrete definitions. It should be exactly like the life is, and the manifestation of life is, it doesn't obey, the life does not obey. It is pure and simply multiplies and it can be interpreted and translated into different ways. And the art is exactly that. Is the way that we are able to translate one thing, but with so many different points of views. And so it's not inside of a context or a definition. And you are part of the first generation of artists after the independence of Angola in 1975. And this fact alone, the fight for independence of your country, it is in a certain way retracted. Do you end up translating that into your work or in the way that you do your art? Well, I'm not sure if I am from the first generation, the generation post the independence. We are actually a product of the political generation. We have many fronts. For example, I see so many Angolan artists, musicians, poets, and it's a really long list that influenced my work. And so, the work that a work of a part of the contemporary artists of Angola, they really translate that. They really talk a lot about our path, about our history as a entity. But you work doing a very interesting mix between the memory of the collective memory of the ancestors with the urban art, which you can find it in the big urban centers through the street art. So how do you actually do this connection, this mixture, or how are you able to do it? I'm not sure how I am able to do it. I do it because of a necessity. a necessity that doesn't end, that I have inside of me, of identifying. I am a product of a society, a colonized society, that supposedly is a society that it's been built after the colonization, meaning inside of its culture, it suffers a huge influence for what it could be in its original way. So I lose a lot of my identity because of this colonization. And so when you look inside and you feel like there is a piece missing, so I really go, I looked for it, I look for this piece. And then we find some common fact between the past, the present, and the future. And I end up actually being open to all of these experiences. I really end up finding a language that is able to maintain some kind of equilibrium, everything that I am able to learn, all of the questions that I am able to absorb, all of my living experiences, being them in my past or the history of the culture, of the civilization of Angola, being them of the influence of the colonialism, or of the path that Angola had after the colonization, being also of the future of Angola in the whole context. And so I'm really able, in some way, I'm able to find some equilibrium in the middle of all of this information. And with my work, you can actually note that in my work. I've been lucky, I believe, to have all of this accessibility and being able to realize things. Not that I have a concrete formula. It's actually very fluid. In a very fluid way, I am able to do it, but I don't really have a certain formula. So I'm able to work freely due to all of this context. Well, I'd like to go to an issue that it was through your interview that I watched that it really called my attention, in which you said that you pretend with your art to be able to decolonize the minds of that person that has a contact or the experience with the artistic process. So how do you work this decolonization of the mind, and what would that be for you? Well, it's the way that I do with myself. I start to deconstroy information because they arrive in a way, and the first question is, it is originally this way that I observed it, and they necessarily have to be that way, or it could be the way that I want. It can start in a way, but it can be transformed in so many different ways. So all of the issues that really move me, they take me to this point. They take me to a way of seeing things as permanent. For example, I have huge pleasure to look at different forms, and this is exactly and so all of the path I like to look into the path of the man into the universe, and I think we should be absolutely free in the way that we interpret the world around us. and we should be able to be free to write our own ideas. And I think it really comes from that, of this effort to deconstruct, to be able to gather many classical formulas of producing the beautiful with formulas that can really be classified as not correct, but they are still the same formulas, but they are being used in a complete different way. And so this is where the creativity remains at. So when you talk about formulas and leaving a little bit the reductions of when you leave the classic formulas, I'd like to make an association with the gender of the retract of the portrait, because inside of the painting it has a huge social function of put a meaning to make present the person that is in the portrait. And there is a predominance, a large one, of the portraits in your graffitis, in your work, in your art. So I'd like to know, who are these people? Who are these people that you put in the portraits? And which is the function that you have in the moment that you are retracting these people?
É mais um exercício que eu faço, na verdade,
Well, when I talk about what I do of being able to get to this point, to get to the message, and to be able to continue having the essence of it. And so the people, in the most part, they are anonymous people that I had the privilege to get to know during my path. And I choose in a certain way. There are so many anonymous people that I meet, but I have a preference for people that I actually start by myself as a condition, and I choose the people that do not have the same conditions of life that I have. Besides, I am a person that has to fight a lot to be able to maintain this, and so I try to absorb conditions of our society, the conditions that these people behave in the society, because these people are produced by the society. They don't come with these conditions, they are actually produced by the society. And so besides the fact that they have to live their experiences in these conditions of poor people or people that have to live in such conditions because of the poverty and have to go through it for so many reasons, they are people with special conditions. And all of these people, they already start with some disadvantages in their lives. But anyway, you always want some intensity. You always want to find some dignity. How do they live their lives? And so I am able to see the reality and the difference of these people related to me when I have the experience to live or to meet them. And so when I transport them to my work, the intention is to maintain exactly what my mind receives from these people. It's exactly the relationship of them to their social conditions upon the community. And so it's really about interpreting the message, of passing on the message of what the society turns us into, and also condition us into.
E eu queria fazer uma outra pergunta em relação,
and I would also like to ask another question related to what you said, that you portray the people that you see, the people that you encounter, that are actually, they are in an environment, in a public environment, in the street environment. And so what does the street, what does the public environment has taught you as an artist, or has shaped you, the way that you see and the way that you interpret and realize the world? Well, it has taught me everything, really. It teaches me everything. It's my biggest school, my biggest background. It's the life itself. It's the capacity that I have to respect it, to observe it, to live with it, and to learn with it. And so the streets really have a really huge meaning for me. Everything that I am able to learn, it comes from the streets. I usually say sometimes that it's not that I usually say it. What usually happens to me, every place that I go, my first look is into the landscape, to the nature. It could be the landscape, could be of the countryside, of the landscape of the city. It's really the first thing. It's from this point that I am able to do an interpretation of this place. And I can really understand if it's a pacific place, if it's a calm place or not, if these people, they are well or not, all through the landscape. So all of the information, I really gather this information from the streets. This is extremely essential for me to be able to live with the environment around me, with the people that I meet. And if it's not in this way, if it's not in this format, I am really, really stuck when I'm going to the arts, because I need to use the information to do something. So, Thó, unfortunately, we have to finish this conversation. It's a really large pleasure every time that we talk, and it's a really, really huge pleasure to learn with you. And I would really like to thank you, because for me, it's very satisfying to receive all of your knowledge, to receive all of your peace. And I really like to thank you. I'd like to really thank you for this one more conversation. I'm the one who thanks you, really, because I don't really know anything. What I do, actually, is I expose with naturality. But I didn't know that I knew so many things. So it's a really huge pleasure for me to listen to this. So thank you very, very much. Well, lots of health for you, to your family, to your dears, to all of the person important to you. Lots and lots of health. And I would like to thank also to the person that, to all the people that is watching and listening and watching us right now, also reflecting on all of this. Thank you so much. And once again, thank you for the Goethe-Institut for allowing us to have this encounter, this virtual encounter with Thó Simões.
Que a conversa de hoje.
And this is the conversation of today, and thank you, Tom. I'm the one who says thank you. I would also like to thank all of you, the Gates Institute. I would also like to thank, send a big, big hug to the people, because I've been in Salvador already, and I've had the privilege to have some friends here in Angola that came from Salvador, and they actually got to know some places in Africa, in other places in Angola. I'd like to send a big hug to these people. I thought I'd be able to hug them this year, but I'm not going to cite names, not to forget anything. But a big kiss to all of you. Thank you so, so much. Thank you very much.